Good morning. We've already learned that an electric charge can experience a magnetic force when moving through a magnetic field, and it equals the cross product of charge times velocity and magnetic field.
Flippin' physics!
Today we are going to learn about the direction of the magnetic force acting on an electric charge moving in a magnetic field. Class, for that, what handy tool do we use?
A compass?
No, what handy tool do we use?
Oh, the right hand rule.
Don't be too cool.
Limber up.
And find your right hand.
All right. The right hand rule for the magnetic force is very much like the right hand rule for torque. Fingers of the right hand point in the direction of the velocity of the electric charge. Fingers of the right hand curl in the direction of the magnetic field. It is good, is a good rule of thumb to start at 90 degrees.
Really?
Rule of thumb.
Thumb on the right hand points in the direction of the magnetic force on a positive charge. For a negative charge, the thumb points 180 degrees from the direction of the magnetic force. Make sure your thumb points normal to the plane created by the velocity of the electric charge and the magnetic field. In other words, realize the direction of the magnetic force is always normal to the plane created by the velocity of the electric charge and the magnetic field. And realize the cross-product version of the magnetic force equation, which uses unit vectors, also gives the direction of the magnetic force. Only rather than using the right-hand rule, it gives you the direction of the magnetic force in terms of unit vectors. All right, let's do some examples. Let's start with a positive charge, which has a velocity to the right and is passing through a uniform magnetic field, which is oriented upwards. Bo, please walk us through the right-hand rule to find the magnetic force acting on this charge.
Fingers of the right hand point to the right. Curl fingers of right hand up. This time it is exactly 90 degrees. Thumb points out of the screen, so the magnetic force is out of the screen.
Thank you, Bo. Notice the symbol for out of the screen is a dot. So this is what a uniform field out of the screen looks like. 180 degrees from that is into the screen. The symbol for into the screen is an X. Therefore, a uniform field into the screen looks like this. The best analogy I have heard for remembering these two symbols is to picture the field being represented by an arrow. For out of the screen, the arrow is coming at you, and the dot represents the tip of the arrow coming at you. For into the screen, the arrow is going away from you, and the X represents the fletching of the arrow as it moves away from you.
Fletching?
It just means the feathers on the back of the arrow.
But arrows only have three feathers, not four.
I agree, Billy. Let's do another one. For this example, we have a uniform magnetic field which is oriented into the screen and a positive charge which has a velocity which is down. Bobby, please determine the direction of the magnetic force on this moving charge.
The fingers of the right hand point down. Fingers curl 90 degrees into the screen. Thumb points to the right. So the magnetic force is to the right.
That is correct, Bobby. Now, at this point, if you are actually physically using your right hand to do these at home, which you absolutely should be doing, you may find that you are having a difficult time getting your body to be able to do this right hand rule example. Some suggestions. Curling just your hand down like this is not a good idea. You want to keep your hand pointing along the direction of your arm. Also, you want to avoid this. The reason this typically happens to you is because you do not actually understand what it means to not be too cool for the right-hand rule, and why I have you limber up. I know that there is nothing cooler than refusing to turn your hips or your shoulders when doing the right-hand rule, but please do not be too cool. Rotate your body, rotate your hips, move your shoulders, be limber for the right-hand rule. Especially in the middle of a test in a crowded classroom. I mean, really, show the rest of the class how flexible and awesome you are.
I'm flexible and awesome. I can turn it every day.
I can move my shoulders.
Look at me. I rotated my hips. Not too cool, am I?
Thank you. Billy, for the next example, we have a positive charge with a velocity to the left, which is experiencing an upward magnetic force. Please determine the direction of the magnetic field.
Velocity is to the left, so our fingers point to the left. We know the direction of the magnetic force. So our thumb points up, and we curl our fingers roughly 90 degrees in the direction of the magnetic field. So the magnetic field is out of the screen.
Thank you, Billy. Now, it is important to recognize that we do not know the exact direction of the magnetic field from this information. Because of the sine of theta in the equation, all we know is that the magnetic field points at some angle out of the screen. Remember, we curl our fingers, and typically I have said to start by curling 90 degrees. However, realize we could curl our fingers anywhere from just over 0 degrees to almost 180 degrees and still have this right-hand rule give the same direction for the magnetic force. So, just to be absolutely clear, we know the magnetic field is out of the screen at some unknown angle. We also know that in order for the magnetic force to be perpendicular to both the velocity and the magnetic field, if there is a component of the magnetic field parallel to the screen, it has to be either aligned with the velocity or opposite to the velocity of the electric charge. For the next example, we have a positive electric charge which is moving downward in a uniform magnetic field, which is down and to the left. Billy, what is the direction of the missing vector?
Point our fingers down in the direction of the velocity, curl our fingers in the direction of the magnetic field, although this time we actually curl our fingers slightly less than 90 degrees, and our thumb points into the screen, so the direction of the magnetic force is into the screen.
Thank you, Billy. Next, we have a negative charge in a uniform magnetic field, which is out of the screen. Bobby? Right. Well done. Without a velocity, there is no magnetic force acting on this negative electric charge. So let's have the negative electric charge be moving to the right.
Okay. Point our fingers to the right in the direction of the velocity. Curl our fingers out of the screen with the magnetic field. And our thumb points down in the direction of the magnetic force. Acting on a positive charge. However, this is a negative charge, so the magnetic force is 180 degrees from that, or up.
Thank you, Bobby. Next, Bo, the directions of the velocity of a negative electric charge and a uniform magnetic field are shown. What is the direction of the magnetic force acting on the negative electric charge?
It is a negative electric charge, so can we just use our left hand?
It's the right hand rule.
So just use a left hand rule for negative charges.
Okay. You need to calm down.
Why? Was I being too loud?
Uh-oh.
You need to just stop.
Right. So while technically you could use a left hand rule for negative charges, I advise against it. My students struggle enough with just finding their right hand that I consider it inadvisable to use a left-hand rule. So my suggestion is to continue only using the right-hand rule and account for the negative charge as an additional last step of flipping the direction of the magnetic force. And there are plenty of teachers who suggest using the left-hand rule. They're not wrong. That is just not the way I prefer to teach it. Believe it or not, not all physics teachers agree with one another. Bob?
Okay, the right hand rule. Fingers point in the direction of the velocity. Curl fingers, actually more than 90 degrees this time, to get the direction of the magnetic field. And our thumb points into the screen. That means because this is a negative charge, that the magnetic force is opposite to into the screen, which makes the magnetic force out of the screen.
Thank you, Bob. One last example. The velocity of the negative charge is up, and the direction of the constant magnetic field is down. Bobby?
Fingers point up in the direction of the velocity. Fingers curl in the direction of the magnetic field. Wait, we could curl our fingers to the right or to the left. Why is that? Okay. The angle between the direction of the velocity and the direction of the magnetic field is 180 degrees, and the sine of 180 degrees is zero. So in this example, there is no magnetic force acting on the moving electric charge.
All right. Going back to the equation definition of the magnetic field, he said a magnetic field is defined by the fact that a moving electric charge in a magnetic field can experience a magnetic force.
Right. When an electric charge is moving parallel or anti-parallel to the direction of the magnetic field, the moving electric charge does not experience a magnetic force.
Anti-parallel?
No. Anti-parallel means parallel but moving or oriented in opposite directions.
Oh, cool. Anti-parallel. You learn something new every day.
I hope you have learned more than just that today.
Meh.
Yeah.
Good point.
Okay. Now, I do want to bring us back to something I said before, because hopefully it will make more sense now. I said, the direction of the magnetic force is always normal to the plane created by the velocity of the electric charge and the magnetic field. Looking at our first example, you can see the plane created by the velocity of the charge and the magnetic field is in the plane of the screen, which I can represent with this sheet of paper.
Paper.
Therefore, the direction of the magnetic force must be normal to the plane of the screen, normal to the sheet of paper. And it is, because the magnetic force is directed toward you or out of the screen. Looking at the second example, the plane created by the velocity and the magnetic field is a vertical plane, which is normal to the plane of the screen, just like this piece of paper. The magnetic force has to be normal to this piece of paper, and it is because the magnetic force is to the right, which is normal to this sheet of paper. And you can see that is true for each of the right-hand rule examples we walked through today. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.